Hi, this is Dr. Vijay. Today we are going to study high density lipoprotein metabolism or HDL metabolism. So before watching this video, you should know some of the basics. For that, please watch this video that is under lipid chemistry playlist, where I have explained basics about lipoproteins, like what are the different classes of lipoprotein, what is the composition, and apoproteins types and their site of synthesis. After watching this video, watch HDL metabolism video. If you haven't subscribed, please subscribe this channel and press the bell icon for future notification. First, we will see how this HDL is synthesized. So whenever the HDL is synthesized, we call it as nascent HDL. And synthesis of this HDL requires both liver as well as small intestine, that is intestinal mucosal cells. The nascent HDL, as mentioned in Harper textbook of biochemistry, it is discoid shape, and also they have mentioned it is phospholipid bilayer. But strictly speaking, it is not a bilayer because it is a monolayer of phospholipid. But the major composition of this nascent HDL is phospholipid. You can see there are monolayer of phospholipids and free cholesterol. You can say there is almost nil cholesterol ester or triglycerides in nascent HDL. As you know, the nascent HDL contains an apoprotein. It is called apolipoprotein A1. It is the major apoprotein of high density lipoprotein, and it plays a pivotal role in HDL metabolism. Among all apoproteins present in the HDL, apo-A1 accounts for 70% of apoproteins present in the HDL. Apart from this, the nascent HDL, when it is released into the circulation, it acquires apolipoprotein C and apolipoprotein E from the liver through the circulation. As it is synthesized, beginning it has got apolipoprotein A1. It is the major apolipoprotein of HDL, and when it reaches the circulation, it acquires apolipoprotein C, mainly C2, and apolipoprotein E, which are synthesized from the liver. So this nascent HDL acquires an important enzyme in HDL metabolism from the liver through the circulation, and the name of that enzyme is LCAT. Again, this enzyme plays a very important role in reverse cholesterol transport mechanism. Function of HDL, we say HDL is a good cholesterol because it removes the cholesterol from the peripheral tissue and hand over to liver, and in the liver it can be metabolized to bile and excreted or secreted to the intestine. So before going to HDL metabolism, you should know something about the enzyme LCAT. The full form of LCAT is lecithin cholesterol acyltransferase. Here we have a lecithin. So the major action of LCAT is it acts on lecithin. You can see here, this is a glycerol backbone. Here we have a fatty acid, and the second carbon atom of glycerol also there is another fatty acid. Whereas third carbon atom of the glycerol backbone esterified with the phosphoric acid and choline. So it is, lecithin is nothing but phosphatidyl choline, a phospholipid. Now, the action of this LCAT It removes fatty acid attached to second carbon atom of the glycerol backbone and handovers this fatty acid to the cholesterol. The third carbon atom or hydroxyl group attached to the third carbon atom of the cholesterol, catalyzed by LCAT. So you can see, as the name suggests, lecithin, cholesterol, acyl means fatty acid, transferase. So LCAT is transferring this acyl group from the lecithin to the cholesterol. Now cholesterol will become cholesterol ester. You can see the R2 or fatty acid, which is attached to second carbon atom of the glycerol backbone, now is esterified with the third carbon atom of the cholesterol, that is esterified with the hydroxyl group of the cholesterol. In turn, this pre-cholesterol become cholesterol ester. So this lecithin, now without the fatty acid, it will become lysolecithin. So this is very important enzyme in HDL metabolism. And the apolipoprotein A1, which is present in the HDL, stimulates this LCAT. So apo-A1 is activator of LCAT. Now we see the metabolism of HDL. We have nascent HDL, which has got apo-A1, LCAT, apo-C and apo-E. So the synthesis of this HDL requires liver as well as intestinal mucosal cell. Now the function of HDL, it removes cholesterol, these are all cholesterol, from extrahepatic tissue or peripheral tissue and hand over this cholesterol to the liver. We don't want any cholesterol accumulation in the peripheral tissue. That might lead to atherosclerosis and cardiovascular disease or cerebrovascular accident. Now this nascent HDL, through the circulation, it comes near the extrahepatic tissues. As the nascent HDL approaches extrahepatic tissue, in the extrahepatic tissues or cell membrane of extrahepatic tissues, there are two types of transporters. The first type of transporter is called ATP binding cassette transporter A1. Simply we can abbreviate it as ABCA1. This transporter present in the cell membrane of peripheral tissues or extrahepatic tissues. The another type of transporter is called scavenger receptor B1. They belong to class B scavenger receptor family. And with the help of these two transporters, this nascent HDL acquires the cholesterol present in the extrahepatic tissue. Because we don't want this cholesterol accumulation in the extrahepatic tissue, it might lead to atherosclerosis. Now, you can see through this transporter, the cholesterol approaching to the nascent HDL, either through ABCA1 or through scavenger receptor B1. Now, once the free cholesterol is coming in contact with the nascent HDL through these two transporter, the LCAT is activated by apo-A1. The apo-A1 apoprotein activates this enzyme, lecithin cholesterol acyl transferase. So we know that these phospholipids, which are present on the periphery of nascent HDL, they are, majority of them are lecithin or phosphatidylcholine. Now once this LCAT is activated, lecithin converted to lysolecithin and this free cholesterol will become cholesterol ester. You can see now fatty acid is esterified with the cholesterol. Now the cholesterol become cholesterol esters. This free cholesterol will become now cholesterol ester. Please note here, the free cholesterol converted to cholesterol ester with the help of LCAT. Now once free cholesterol is converted to cholesterol ester, it will migrate to the interior of the nascent HDL because it is hydrophobic. Only free cholesterol occupies periphery of the lipoprotein. So when they become cholesterol ester, they will migrate to the inner core or central core of the lipoprotein. Here in this case, it is nascent HDL. So like this, through this ABCA1 and SRB1, whatever cholesterols, free cholesterols, they are effluxed into the nascent HDL and they will go interior or central core of the nascent HDL. And now this nascent HDL will become spherical in shape. Initially it is discoid in shape. Now because of migration of this cholesterol ester, because they are hydrophobic, so this discoidal nascent HDL will become now spherical HDL. This HDL is called HDL2. Once there is formation of HDL2, it will hand over some of its cholesterol esters to VLDL. You can see this is a VLDL. VLDL contains triglycerides and cholesterol esters in the central dense core. Now this HDL2, it will hand over some of its cholesterol ester to the VLDL, and in exchange it will receive some of the triglycerides. Now this HDL2 will become HDL3. This exchange is mainly by a protein called cholesterol ester transport protein, CETP. The function of cholesterol ester transport protein is exchange of cholesterol ester and triglycerides between HDL2 and VLDL. So now this HDL or HDL3 is called mature HDL. Now this HDL taken to liver through a receptor. Again, it is the same receptor, scavenger receptor B1. So scavenger receptor B1 has got dual role. So it helps in efflux of the cholesterol from the extrahepatic tissue to the nascent HDL, as well as intake of this HDL, that is mature HDL, from the circulation to the liver. So this receptor also called HDL receptor. So by this way, HDL helps in reverse. So this cholesterol, we don't want this cholesterol accumulated in the peripheral tissue or extrahepatic tissue. So that is why the HDL is called good cholesterol, and the mechanism is called reverse cholesterol transport. So once cholesterols are transported from the peripheral tissue to the liver, in the liver we know that it can be converted to bile and released into the intestine. This is actually the metabolism of HDL. You should remember the initial HDL, which is synthesized with the help of small intestinal mucosal cells and liver, it is called nascent HDL. And it is, you can say, almost devoid of cholesterol ester and triglyceride. It is mainly made up of phospholipids and free cholesterol. And the major apolipoprotein is A1, apo-A1, and it has got an important enzyme LCAT. Apart from this, it receives two apolipoprotein C and E from the liver. It acquires excess cholesterol deposited in the peripheral tissue through these two receptors, ABCA1 and SRB1. Once they acquire free cholesterol, the LCAT esterifies this free cholesterol to cholesterol ester, and it will be migrated to inner core of the nascent HDL, and HDL will become spherical in shape. It is called HDL2, and some of the cholesterol esters it handovers to VLDL in exchange with triglycerides with the help of CETP, cholesterol ester transport protein. Now this will become HDL3, and this HDL3 is taken to the liver with the help of HDL receptor or scavenger receptor B1. This is with respect to HDL metabolism. Thanks for watching.